Hello everyone. So today we'll be exploring Ohm's law with the help of FET simulation. And in this session we have GN, Ravi, Surnava, Kiran with us. So hello guys.
Hi guys.
Hi.
Hello Ashish.
Yeah. So let's get into the session and explore this Ohm's law. So as you can see, like we are on the landing page of Ohm's law simulation, which is by FET. So we also call it FET simulation. Okay, so my questions to all the participants over here is like, what are the things like which is visible on the screen?
So as it is Ohm's law, so I can see the equation written, which is the formula V is equals to IR.
Mm-hmm.
And the circuit below it.
Okay. So as Kiran helped us, like there is V is equal to IR. So I can see like I is too small. Okay, so we will explore like why I is too small over there.
And why is V and R so big?
Yeah, so why V and R is so big. Okay, and we also have on the right hand side the slider. So as you can see, the slider of for voltage V and for resistance R. And at the bottom, center of the bottom, like we have a small circuit. So what I can predict from the circuit is like we have this 1.5 volt cell kind of thing or a battery kind of thing. And there are three batteries. And then we have some one conductor. And in the center of the circuit, the current is flown through the arrow and the direction is also given through the arrow. And in the center, we have this current value is there. Okay, cool. So we have this conductor. So in conductor, I can see there are some small black dots. So we'll explore, we'll find out like what are these dots. And okay, and then why the battery is given with 1.5 volt. Okay, so before proceeding, can we check like by varying the value of this voltage? I mean, can we check the slider?
Yeah, sure, Ashish. Do you want me to increase it?
Yeah. So you can increase it. Yeah. Okay, cool. So from here, I think the idea is like by increasing the voltage, we can add more voltage to the circuit. Okay, cool. So can we decrease it also?
Okay, so.
Okay, the letters represent the amount of voltage.
Yeah.
So letters represent the amount of voltage and I represents the amount of current in this case.
Okay. Yes, I remains same, is it, all the time?
No, it is increasing and decreasing. Yeah, as you increase the voltage and decrease the voltage.
Oh, yes.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, do you all also hear the sound? Or is it only I can hear the...
No, we can hear it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So on increasing voltage, so current is also increasing, but why there is no effect on the resistance, the word R?
Yeah. So that's interesting. Yeah. So we'll explore this question. So can we also check the slider for resistance?
Yes.
Okay. So fine. Oh. Okay, so this is now interesting. So now like we have the letter I getting bigger when we are decreasing the resistance. Okay,
and also the current means the arrows indicating the currents are also becoming big and small.
Mm-hmm. okay
yes, nice. Okay, yes, I didn't see that.
Okay. So like before getting into this expression, which is V is equal to IR, I just wanted to know like, what is V and what is I and what is this R? So can we have a short description around this thing or a brief discussion around this thing, these things?
Yeah, below the V is written now, voltage.
Yeah, so I mean like, what do we mean by voltage?
Mm-hmm. It is voltage across the conductor, right?
Okay. So voltage across the conductor.
isn't voltage a measure of potential difference?
I think yes. So in other terms, you also called it a potential difference. Yes.
So then voltage is potential difference.
Okay, so voltage is potential difference. Okay, so I got this rough idea, like, yeah, voltage is potential difference. Okay, so similarly, can we come up with something for current, which is represented by I?
So I is current, and current is due to flow of electrons.
Yeah.
Current generates due to the flow.
Interesting, interesting. So current is due to flow of electrons. Okay, nice. Yeah. And
electrons flowing per unit time in a unit cross section area. That's how I think we define current.
Okay, okay. So you mean to say like the electrons flowing per unit time, right? So I mean through a cross
section. Yeah, in a cross section area of the conductor. If we take a particular cross section area, so per unit time, like how many electrons are, net electrons are flowing, I think, depending on that, we can calculate the charge. So charge per unit time essentially gives the current.
Okay. Yeah, this is interesting. So keeping it simple, we only consider now, right, the current is charge per unit time, right? And in a simple language, we can say current is something like which represents the flow of electrons. And like in generic term, we can call it like flow of electric charges, right?
Hmm.
Okay, so now we have one more term, which is resistance over there. So what do we mean by resistance?
So resistance, I don't know much, but I can say that it should be hindering something, which is resisting something, I guess.
Okay, yeah. So resistance is some kind of a hindrance, but hindrance to what?
To current. To the flow of electrons.
Okay, so it is so we can say like it is opposed to the flow of current, right?
Yes.
And we also, like, I think we also saw that when we were increasing the resistance, so current was decreasing. So when we were playing with the slider,
yeah,
few minutes back, yeah.
Right. Okay, so now we have a rough idea of like what is V, what is I, and what is IR, right? So to conclude all these three terms, so like V is the voltage, which we are also calling it as potential difference. And it is something which is pushing the charges to move in a circuit, right? And then we have a current, which is indicated by this or the letter I. And we are calling like it is a flow of charges. And then we have this over there, right? So resistance is something which is opposing the flow of charges. Okay, cool. So, I mean, quickly, can we also understand what are these terms? MA is there written for the current, V is written there for the current, and some symbol is there for the resistance.
Yeah.
Yes, so can we like understand like what are these symbols or what does this indicate?
So ampere is actually the current measure like in the ampere.
Okay. So, I mean, with this, we mean to say like we measure the current in the unit ampere, right?
Yes.
Cool. So ampere is the unit of current. Okay. So similarly for voltage, we have
V, which is voltage only.
Okay. Yeah. So V is the voltage, right? So we measure the voltage in volts, right?
Volt.
Okay, so V stand for volts, and then we have the unit for resistance is
ohms,
right? So this is the symbol of ohms, after 94. Okay, so this is ohm. Okay, so resistance is measured in unit ohm. Okay, so now, like, as we have understood these three terms, so I think this expression is telling us some relation between all these three terms. So V is equal to IR, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now, like, we have this voltage of 6 volt and resistance of 94 ohm, and we have a current here 63.8 milliampere. Okay, so how this expression is working, right? So we can explore now. So as the definition or as the term voltage indicates, So it is something which actually provides some force or the electric pressure for to push the charges into the circuit, right? So it actually lead to the flow of current. So, but now, we also have some resistance over there. So here resistance will oppose the flow of current, right? So now what we can do, we can eliminate the resistance by sliding it down to zero.
Okay, so I think the minimum value which we can get here is 10 ohms.
Okay.
And then, you know, this I drastically increased.
Yeah. And also, the simulation is considering that there is no ideal case where resistance can be zero, right? So there there will be some minimum value for the resistance. Okay, so like when we are considering this voltage is equal to 6 volt and resistance is equal to 10 ohm, so then we have a current.
Yeah. And that is around 600 milliamps.
Okay, so the 600 milliampere.
Yeah. Actually, if we divide 6 by 10, we get 0.6 amperes. To convert that into milliamps, so we multiply it by 1000. So 0.6 into 1000, we get 600. So that's why I think it's written 600 milliamps according to this formula.
Okay. So, can we say if there is no resistance, can we say like voltage is directly proportional to the current?
Mm. Yeah, I was thinking of Kiran's point, like which she was mentioning in the beginning, that on changing the voltage, we can see the I is being changed. Mm-hmm. And also on changing the R, only I is being changed, not the V. So somehow just playing with these parameters give us this clue that I is the one which is being dependent on V and R.
Okay,
I see something happening. So when R is changing, I is changing inversely.
Yes.
Okay.
So I and R are inversely related. So that means if you increase the resistance, the current will decrease.
Yes, if you increase the resistance, the current will decrease, yes.
Because the size-wise, I can see that in the picture. Like if R is increasing, I is decreasing.
Yeah.
So now we have a relationship between the resistance and the current. So can we also see the relationship between resistance and voltage by using this slider? Can we come up with some relation between them?
They're not depending on each other. Maybe looking like that seems to be the properties of the experiment itself. Like, that means you increase the number of batteries, then voltage will increase, right? So, and if you change the conductor, then resistance will change.
Yeah.
Right? Because you can't change the conductor just like that, right? In a sense.
Yeah.
So voltage you can increase by adding batteries. More and more batteries.
Yeah. So here one thing which is noticeable is that even if you increase the voltage, there will be the change in the current, right? There will be no effect on the resistance because over here resistance is a fixed. It is a fixed parameter of that particular conductor.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So now, can we also come up with some relationship, direct relationship between V and I, that is voltage and current? So can we use the slider and check
Yes, they're directly proportional.
Cool. So by keeping the value of the resistance fixed, we can see as we are increasing the voltage, our I is also increasing, and as decreasing the voltage, our our I is also decreasing. Okay, so this tells us that V is directly proportional to I. Cool.
So do we have a statement of Ohm's law so that now we can see the relationship between them. So can we look what does Ohm's law say? Does the Ohm's law say that the voltage is directly proportional to current at a given resistance?
I think yes. So if we open the Wikipedia and from Wikipedia we can read Ohm's law states that the current through a conductor between two points is directly proportional to the voltage across the two points. So I think these two points is the point across the conductor. So the current through this conductor, right? The current which is flowing through this conductor, which is between the two points, right, is directly proportional to the voltage across these two points. So we can say V is directly proportional to the I.
So in Wikipedia, it is written I is equal to V by R.
Okay.
Yeah, and the resistance is introduced as a constant of proportionality between the current and the voltage.
Correct.
So I think, can we take the help of a whiteboard to actually, write these statements? So it will make us more clear towards Ohm's law.
Sure. So Ashish, do you want me to take a screenshot maybe of certain value and then which we can put it up on the whiteboard and discuss further?
Yeah.
So let's then think of some number which makes it easier for us to even look at the relationship.
So keep voltage 3.
Uh-huh.
Okay, 3. So one more. And resistance maybe.
Keep it 20.
So
maybe 20, maybe 30.
Yeah.
30.
100 is good.
Okay. It's little tricky to get the exact value.
Yeah, 105 is okay.
Okay. So approximately 100, we have resistance and the current which we can see here is around 28 milliamperes.
Okay, so welcome back. So now we have the screenshot image of the simulation. So as simulation is allowing right there. So the screenshot image of the simulation and we have uploaded it on the web, our whiteboard. And now write some of the noticeable things, right? Okay, so let's start.
So Ashish, as we discussed that, resistance and current should be inversely proportional, but why? From the circuit, can we understand that why, if the current is more, the resistance should be low?
Okay.
Or vice versa?
Yeah. Okay. So at first, let me write as you're saying, current is inversely proportional to resistance, right? So is this right? The way of writing current is inversely proportional to the resistance.
When V is constant, I guess that is necessary. When V and other parameters are constant.
Okay. So here we are saying we have to keep the V constant. Okay. So now, as in the circuit, we have a V. Okay. So 1.5 volt plus 1.5 volt. So we have a 3 volt over here, right? So 3 volt. Of voltage applied across this conductor. So over here we have this conductor, right? And now the resistance is 105 ohm, which is 105 ohms, right? So I can write 105 ohms. Okay. So for this value of resistance and for this value of voltage, we are getting the current 28.6 milliampere. Okay. So now what we can do, keeping the voltage constant, let's increase the resistance and check the current.
Okay. Now let us, so the expectation is that the current will decrease if you increase resistance.
Okay, okay. So
the right current is 48.
Yeah.
So let's double the values, like double the resistance.
Okay, let's see.
Okay, so for that, yeah.
Okay, and then so that is our expectation. So we'll go to simulation after we write down the expectations.
Okay, okay, yeah.
Okay, so let us make it around 200 in the resistance.
Mm-hmm.
So we have kept the voltage constant.
Okay, so over here we have voltage is equal to 3 volts.
So current should be around 14.
14.3 milliampere.
Something like that. Around 14.3. Depends on whether we can get resistance exactly like 210.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
So,
okay. So now we can go back to the simulation and make those values. So you can write down that the expected value is 14.3.
Yeah, so this is our expected value, 14.3. Okay, I've make a note.
Okay, so Ravi, can you go back to the simulation and try? Okay. So now make it 210.
Okay. Oh, so it is increasing.
Yeah, 208. Yeah, 14.4 because it's 208, not 210.
Yeah, yeah. So
okay, so now think that actually simulation is nothing but equation, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, just a visualization of the equation.
Exactly, exactly. And also, like the Kiran asked one question, like why it is like on increasing the resistance the current is decreasing and vice versa. So can I draw all of your attention towards like the black dots inside the conductor?
So yeah.
Okay, so now can we increase the resistance full and check like what is happening with these black dots? Okay. Oh, nice.
So that's basically like some resistant.
Yeah, so
the more those things, the lesser the current will be.
Yeah, yeah. So I think the simplest example would be like the number of more this speed breakers on the roads. So it will reduce the speed of yours, right? You cannot increase the speed because the moment you increase the speed, the another speed breaker will come, right? So you have to drive slow. So similarly, like as we are increasing the resistance, so as you can we can clearly see in this conductor, like the number of black dots are increasing. So they are actually providing the hindrance to the flow of electric charges. Or as Kiran also stated, the flow of electrons, right? So the more resistance, more black dots, and it will not allow the electrons to flow easily, right? There will be hindrance, there will be opposed to the flow of electrons. So therefore, there will be less current through the circuit.
Suppose I have a copper wire of a given length.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if I want to increase the resistance, I can't change the material because the only thing that I have is copper wire.
Yeah.
The lab. So why can't I increase the resistance by just increasing the length of the wire?
Yeah, yeah. So we can do that. So,
okay. So which means basically that if you are increasing the length, you are also automatically increasing those black dots because to that length.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So we will come to one more simulation later during these sessions. So where we will actually understand like how the resistance of a piece of a conductor, on what parameter it depends. So there are some parameter like there is a area of cross section, length of a wire, and the resistivity. So we will also explore the resistivity, length of wire, and area of cross section on which this resistance of a conductor depends.
Okay. Good. So as it is shown on the Ohm's law page on Wikipedia, so the equation can also be written as I is equal to V by R.
Yes, yes, yes. So I think now this is a very interesting thing. So can we again go back to the whiteboard and can we like I mean, write some expressions so that we can come to I is equal to V upon R.
We got back. Yes.
Cool. So as we can see, like over here, we got these expressions, right? As per like watching the simulation carefully, we observe this. So like on increasing the resistance and keeping the voltage constant, our current is also increasing and decreasing, right? So similarly, we also got one statement, a through Ohm's law statement, which is like the current flowing through a conductor, right? So in the simulation here, we have this conductor. So now say current I is flowing through it. So I can mark with a arrow. So this is a current I, right? So Ohm's law states that the current flowing through this conductor is directly proportional to the voltage across it, right? So now what is the voltage across it? This plus and minus 3 volt, right? So I can also write this is plus and over here we have minus, right? So I can write we have a 3 volt across this conductor. So this current I which is flowing across this conductor is directly proportional to the voltage crosses. So now we have two of this noticeable expression which we got through the statement and also through the simulation, right? So on the Wikipedia, it is showing like we can also write I is equal to V upon R. So keeping the derivation simple, I just want to relate the thing like I is equal to V upon R is showing us that I is inversely proportional to the resistance and I is directly proportional to the voltage. Okay, so this is the simple
Ravi, Kiran.
Yeah,
so I have a question, but I don't know whether it is related to the equation. Since current is a flow of electron, mm-hmm. and electron has negative charge, and as you said that this is the resistance, so it mm-hmm. will hinder the flow of electron, but how? Because electron is negatively charged. So what is happening inside this the resistance, how it is hindering the flow of electrons?
Yeah, so this is interesting question. So I just want to like put this point like we need to first understand like how basically the electric charges flows, right? So yeah, anyone would like to put discussion around this?
I guess the electric charges flow through a wire. It happens just when they have loosely bound electrons, right? So yeah. The electrons will jump from one atom to the other atom, and like the continued chain will be there. From one atom, the electron from A from 1 to 2, then 2 to 3, then 3 to 4, like that the electron flows. So the hindrance probably I could think of is one of the nuclear charge, and because that is mm-hmm. attracting the electrons, so that may be one of the hindrance which is there inside this material.
So you mean to say that there must be the opposite charge, that the positive charge that should hinder the flow of the negative charges?
Yes. Means the positive charge can attract the electrons which are there free flowing, so they may hinder with the nucleus charge is there, right? So they are not allowing the electron to completely go outside of their atom, neutral atom, so they are quite bound. But I guess the charge and the wire, the quality of the wire depends, means how freely the electron can flow, that is basically the resistance. Actually means the electron, the more free is the electron to flow, the less will be the resistance, and the more it is tightly bound towards the nucleus, the more will be the resistance.
But anyway, the electrons that are bound to the nucleus are not part of the electricity, right? So why don't we say that the number of free flowing electrons is basically what we're talking about when we're talking about R? That means more the number of free electrons in the material, more current will be there.
Yeah. So as Jian also indicates, like we need to focus on the free electrons. So just would like to bring.
Maybe what we can do is in some other session, we can actually look at the chemical properties of some of the conductors,
yeah,
and then correlate that with the resistance that they offer.
I think yes, we can do that. Yeah,
that can be another discussion that we can have. Since we already had a long conversation on this, I think we'll open up some of these questions. The Kiran's question, maybe we can try to answer in the next session.
I think yes. So okay, so cool. So we have seen like this V is equal to IR. We have understand like we have the current which is inversely proportional to the resistance of that conductor, and then we have a current which is directly proportional to the conductor. Directly proportional to the voltage across the conductor. Okay, so this is our V is equal to IR.
Yep.
Yeah. Thanks, Ashish.